Hey everyone, my name is Johnny and I'm a drummer living in Toronto, Canada. And today I just wanted to share a few of my memories about going to legendary guitar player Jeff Healy's club in Toronto in the early 2000s. Jeff Healy was a Canadian guitar virtuoso specializing in blues and jazz guitar. His music reached the top 5 in the US Billboard charts as well as the top 10 in the Canadian charts over the years. He was kind of referred to as Canada's Stevie Ray Vaughan and was an amazing guitar player. Jeff Healy was notable for playing his guitar in a very unique style, which was having the guitar placed on his lap facing upwards. And he would play like it was almost a piano. It was a very unique style of playing. Another fact about Jeff Healy is that at a very young age, he suffered from a rare form of cancer that caused him to go blind. So Jeff Healy was a blind guitar player. He sold millions of copies of music over the years, and his rendition of While My Guitar Gently Weeps is something that you have to see to believe. I'll definitely put a link below, so check it out. So, having been born in Toronto, Jeff Healy eventually opened up his own club in the city. The first time I heard about him having a club was through my first band called the Steady Rollers, and I mentioned them in my first video. We were a young and eager, kind of blues, 70s influenced band, and the rest of the members of the band, they knew about Jeff Healy's bar, and they had heard that there was an open jam that would happen every Tuesday at Healy's. So, they asked if I wanted to go. So I said, sure. I was 17 at the time and in grade 11, and I got my license months earlier, right on my 17th birthday, so I was the driver. So I kind of went around, and it took me forever to pick these guys up. Classic musician fashion, you know, but we finally all got together in my car. Our singer, Mike, printed out the directions from MapQuest.com. I don't know if you guys remember MapQuest. That was before Google Maps or Waze, and we had these instructions on how to get down there. And Healy's club was located right at Queen and Bathurst, which was an interesting part of town. It was a little bit of a rough part of town in those days. There was a lot of characters walking the streets, but there were cool venues in the area. And actually, right across the street from Healy's was the Big Bop, which was a music concert complex that had 3 venues, the Cathedral, the Reverb, and Holy Joe's in the back. So it was a cool part of town with a lot of culture, but it was definitely a little rough around the edges. So we finally got down there, we parked a block and a half away, and we walked to the place carrying our instruments and me with my drumsticks. We finally arrived at it, Healy's, and it was just this sign with a door, and you go in the door and you walk downstairs. So this is a basement venue. I remember immediately when you walk in, there was just this smell. It was almost kind of a moldy smell mixed with like cleaner and disinfectant. I'm not saying it was a bad smell or anything. It was just an interesting smell that I remember every time going in there. It was very unique. So you go down these stairs and then you turn to the left and then immediately turn to the right and then you see the venue. And it was your kind of standard, kind of smaller club venue. You had the sound booth to the right, the bar to the left, and the stage right at the back. And everything was kind of dark and, you know, just the stage was lit. I remember when we got in there, kind of first order was business, was to find the person who hosted the open jam night and sign up for a slot. And I think I remember getting a pretty late slot that first night. But we got in there, we were excited, we put our guitars to the side of the stage. We got a seat at the front and we just kind of watched. And what was really cool about this night is that there was a house band that would play, and if you wanted to do the open jam, you could come as a full band and you could use all of the gear, meaning you could use a full drum kit, you could use the amps. It was just really easy to get up and perform. Also, if you were a solo performer, you could get up and perform with this amazing backing band, which often had some of the top musicians in the city. And I remember that the night started off with a comedy portion, kind of an open mic for comedy. And it was hosted by Glenn Foster, also known as That Canadian Guy, who's a Canadian comic who's been on TV and who's had some success. So it was really cool to see him there. And he would kind of get the crowd all fired up and then welcome some of the other comedians. And then after that, it was music time. So we hung around and we got to see some great acts. And then finally, we got up on stage and performed. And it was late at this point. And I remember there weren't a lot of people in the crowd. But whatever, we got up there. We were young, 17 and 18 years old. And we got to play in Toronto on a Tuesday night. I remember at the end of the night, finally driving everyone home. I got home past 2 a.m. And I remember I had to get up early for school the next morning, which sucked. But it was just a cool experience. I remember after that first jam, my band would call me every week to see if I could go to the open jam at Healy's. And it was tough because I couldn't really do that 2 a.m. thing every Tuesday. I played hockey some nights and I had other extracurricular activities, so it was tough. But eventually I came around and we went to that jam quite a bit. And it was just so cool because you never knew who you would see on a given week. I remember one time we went and we saw a guy named Tony Springer play, and he just blew my mind. He was like this guy who kind of had this Jimi Hendrix flair. It was just amazing. And it was only later that I found out he was a Toronto music legend with his band Wild Tea and the Spirit. So we got to see him. I remember oftentimes there would be great drummers behind the kit in the house band, one of which was Chris Lesso, who's kind of a top player in the Toronto drum scene, especially at that time. So it was great to kind of be in the presence of these musicians, even though we maybe didn't know it at that exact moment. And it was cool because we got a lot of encouragement from the people and musicians that were there. A lot of people really liked what we were about, although I'm sure we were rough around the edges at that point in our careers. But I definitely remember feeling also a sense of, you know, you guys are the young bucks and you got to put in your time and pay your dues. So I did feel that. But looking back, I know that these guys were just kind of putting the pressure on and weeding us out because they must have had so many young kids come in there and try and play and, you know, think they were on top of the world. And I think a bit of a reality check was just needed and maybe kind of what they went through going up. So it was interesting to kind of be put through that kind of ringer. But I don't even mean that in a bad way. Like the staff, everyone was super cool and amazing and so supportive of what we did. We actually played one of the Battle of the Bands that they hosted there and we had such a great night. I remember a few months later after doing a few more of the open mics, after we performed, I went to the bar and I was kind of just looking to get a glass of water or whatever because, like I said, I was 17. Maybe at this point I had just turned 18, but I went to the bar to get a drink. And I remember the bartender came up to me and asked, "What beer do you want?" And I said, "What do you mean?" And she was like, "Oh, you just performed, right? All of the performers get a free beer." And I was like, "What can I get?" And she said, "You know, whatever is on tap." And I just ended up ordering something. So I got a free beer underage at Jeff Healy's. I don't even know if I should be saying this, but it doesn't matter. It was pretty cool at the time. And it wasn't like a pint or anything. It was just this kind of small cup of beer, but it just felt really cool to kind of be drinking underage. And I remember the next day at school, you know, I got home at like 2 a.m. the night before and I was in music class. And I remember telling my buddies, "Yo, I got to have a beer last night at Jeff Healy's. It was awesome." And everyone thought it was so cool. And I remember because it was the same bartender every time, the free beer after every open jam kind of became a bit of a tradition that we would have. Another reason that we loved going to Jeff Healy's was that we all secretly hoped that we would one day potentially see the legend himself, Jeff Healy, at one of the jam nights. But Jeff Healy never showed up to any of the jam nights. But one day, we happened to be playing a show across the street at the Reverb in the Big Bop complex. And it was a Saturday, and we had heard that Jeff Healy would perform every Saturday at his club with his jazz band. So, after our sound check, we snuck across the street, and I think we kind of snuck into his venue somehow. Not snuck in, but I think the door person knew us, and it was kind of at the end of the show, and just let us in. So we were like, amazing. We walked down the stairs, went in, turned to the left, turned to the right, and the place was packed. And there at the end where the stage was Jeff Healy. And I just remember seeing him. He was playing trumpet, and he kind of had a unique way of playing trumpet out of the side of his mouth, which later I learned was kind of his signature. But I remember just seeing him playing, and we were just in awe. There he was, Jeff Healy, the man himself. We kind of hung out at the back and were watching for a bit, and eventually he picked up his guitar and in his classic style put the guitar on his lap and was kind of playing almost like a piano. It was so cool to see, and he even started rocking out more. He would get up and be playing the guitar like this, standing up. It was so interesting to see such a unique style of playing, but his playing was just so incredible. It was amazing to see, and I'm so happy that we got to see him perform. A few years later, in late 2006, Healy's Club actually closed and a new one was opened, and it was branded as Jeff Healy's Roadhouse Bar. It was located at 56 Blue Jays Way, and that was kind of in a more touristy part of town. It was right near Wayne Gretzky's, and it was near Second City, the comedy club. So it was in a more populated area. And actually, in an interview that Jeff Healy did with Now Magazine in Toronto, Jeff said of his old venue, "I never intended Healy's being there as long as we were. Who really wants to go down to Queen and Bathurst unless you really have to anymore?" He also mentioned in that same interview that his old club was an awkward mid-sized venue, too big for intimate artists and too small for big ticket artists. So those were just kind of his thoughts on the old venue. I know when they opened Jeff Healy's Roadhouse Bar at the new location, Jeff Healy wasn't actually an owner of the new venue, but he kind of supported it and played there quite a bit. And kind of as soon as that new venue opened, my band booked a few gigs there. It was a bit of a bigger space. It had a nice modern stage, and the vibe was really great in there. They had state-of-the-art gear and lighting rigs, and it was really nice. But sadly, that venue too closed down. And in fact, on March 2nd, Jeff Healy, the legend himself, passed away at the age of 41 from a rare form of cancer. And we were so sad to hear of his passing because, aside from being a Canadian icon and an internationally renowned blues and jazz guitar player, Jeff Healy was so a part of the Toronto culture. I remember even one day just walking down the streets of Toronto with my friends one afternoon, and we saw Jeff Healy kind of arm in arm with someone walking down the street, and I was like, "Guys, that's Jeff Healy," and we were all kind of starstruck. He was definitely a part of the culture of Toronto, and to lose him at such a young age, it was very tragic. And I know the city of Toronto lost a great musician and a dear friend to many on that day. So I hope you enjoyed my story about my memories about Jeff Healy's original bar and then later Jeff Healy's Roadhouse Club. I know I may have not been there as much as some of the other people out there, so if you do have any stories about either of his clubs or just have cool stories about Jeff Healy himself or maybe playing with him or having an encounter with Jeff Healy, I'd love to hear about them. Please comment below and tell me your stories. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.